Good afternoon, children. In the last class, we had studied tourism in both Brazil and India. Today, we are going to study transport in Brazil, textbook page number 63 and 64. Study the transport map of Brazil in figure 9.3 and answer the following questions. Let us look at the questions. First one. Which means of transport are seen on the map? Children, in this map, all the means of transport like roadways, airways, railways and waterways we can see on the map. Okay. Second one, which means of transport has dense network? The roadways have a dense network in Brazil. Next question, which highway can be seen prominently? Which place does it join? The prominent highway we can see, that is known as Trans-Amazon Highway. We can see in the map. It connects important cities like Cruzeiro do Sul, Porto, Velho, Manaus and Brasilia. Next question. What could be the reason for the development of railway in the southeast? The most important reason is southeast Brazil is the richest and this area is a most populated region. Okay. Next question. In which part of Brazil do you see a lesser development of transport network? What could be the reason? Amazon in the north and Pantanal in the west have a lesser development of transport network. The reason behind that is Amazon in the north due to dense forest cover, whereas Pantanal is a swampy land. Swampy land means wet land. And hence the transport network is not developed in these areas. Okay. Now let us come to geographical explanation. The most common method of transportation in Brazil is roadways. Children, more than half of the transportation system in the country is road transportation. The density of network is concentrated in the eastern part of the country, because this region is densely populated area. Already we saw in the map that the forested land of Amazon River basin and the swampy land means wetland, have limited development of roadways in the northwestern part of Brazil. Another transportation in Brazil is water transport. Water transport is carried out in the Amazon River on a commercial basis, and the boats ply from Iquitos in Peru in the mouth of the river. Children, this waterway is considered as the longest waterway in the world. It is around 3,700 kilometer length. Another important south flowing river in Brazil is Parana. It is also an important river for water transportation in Brazil. Coastal shipping also carried out in the coastal areas in Brazil. Next, railway. Railway have not much developed well in Brazil. It is one of the cheaper means of transport, but it is restricted to a few urban tourist routes due to topography of the country or uneven physiography of the country. The contribution of airways is also less in the transportation system of the country. Few airports are here in Brazil. Okay. Now, next one is page number 64, we are going to study transportation system in India. Look at the transport maps of India given in figure 9.10. 9.10 is showing national highways and major ports in India. 9.11 is important airways routes and airports are showing. So we have to observe the map and have to answer the following questions. Let us come to first question. Which means of transport are visible on the map? Children, figure 9.10 shows national highways and port. The means of transport used are roadways and waterways. And in figure 9.11 shows railway route and airport. The means of transport used are airways and railways. Second question. In which part of India is the density of railways more? The density of railways is more in the northern plains region. Next question, name five important port and airports in India. Important port in India are Mumbai, Visakhapatnam, Haldia, Chennai and Kandal. Important airports are Delhi, Mumbai, Bengaluru, Chennai and Kolkata. Okay. Which part of India have a spare network or less network of transport? What could be the reason? Of course, the north and the northeast part of India have a spare network of transport. The reason behind that is this area is a mountainous region and snow-covered area in the north and dense inaccessible forest areas of the northeast. The transportation network is spare here. Also, this region have a low population and a lack of economic opportunities. Okay. Now, children, let us come to geographical explanation. India has a denser network of transport as compared to Brazil. All type of transport, all modes and means of transport. In India, about 85% of passengers and 70% of freight traffic. Freight traffic means, children, transportation of goods are carried by road every year. Goods and passengers transport have been facilitated due to the development of the railways. Railways in India play an important role in the economical growth of the country. We have dense railway network in the North Indian plains, but it is relatively less dense in the hilly states, northeastern states, central parts of India and Rajasthan. Railways are very important for a vast country like India. Next, waterways. Waterways are considered as cheap means of transport. Waterways contributing about 1% to the country's transportation. It is carried out by rivers, canals, backwaters, creeks, etc. Next, learn, we are going to study transportation of goods through waterways. Approximately 95% of India's foreign trade moves through ocean route. Not only that, apart from international trade, oceans are also used for the purpose of transportation between the islands and the rest of the country. Children, as compared to Brazil, airways in India are more developed and the use of internal airways also increasing. Next topic, always remember, you need to understand the development of means of transport is an indicator of rapid progress of a country. So from this topic we come to understand India is rapidly progressing in a transportation area. Today, children, we stop here. Next class we will study communication in both Brazil and India. Complete your assignment.